Audience, we ready? Awesome. Hey, guys. How are we doing? Good. How's RSA going so far? Pretty well? Okay. All right, it's day two, so we still got 3 days left. But my name is Kelly Anderson, and I'm the product marketing manager for Azure Security and Azure Security services that fall into that bracket. So I am super excited to be here today at RSA to tell for the first time to a broad audience our end-to-end Azure Security story. So before I get started, just a quick show of hands if you feel comfortable. How many of you are currently using Azure? Okay. How many of you are thinking about using Azure and Azure is in your vocabulary? Okay. All right. Thank you for being honest. So to kick things off, we're going to talk about the security landscape and what we're seeing. And what we're currently seeing with our customers is there's a wide distribution of infrastructure. We see that a lot of customers, they're having their data and applications running on premises. It's running in the public cloud, and it's running in the hybrid cloud as well. And so having that wide distribution of infrastructure is making it more challenging for you to maintain a strong security posture. And so some of those challenges that we see is a rising cost. So it is increasingly more expensive for you to maintain your own infrastructure without seeing a clear return of investments. Another challenge that we're seeing is that it is more challenging for enterprises to retain and recruit security experts needed to navigate the security landscape. We're also seeing an increase in the number of threats. And unfortunately, that number is not going to go down anytime soon. And so we're seeing a lot of security professionals trying to make sense of what is a legitimate threat and what is just noise. And then the last challenge we see is there is an increased number of security solutions that our customers are using. So in fact, we know that 65% of IT professionals use at least 6 or more security vendors, and 65% of IT security professionals use 6 or more security solutions. So with all of these challenges, moving to the cloud becomes the new imperative, because moving to the cloud can not only help you reduce the cost and complexity, but it can also help you understand and respond to threats quicker. And so when we think about the ways that Azure can strengthen our security posture, we break it down into three main areas. We start with a secure foundation, and these are things that Microsoft will do when you sign up to be an Azure customer. Then we give you built-in security controls to help you protect your data and your business assets and mitigate risks quickly. So what this means is when you go to the Azure portal and you are in the Azure marketplace, you will see a variety of first-party and third-party services that you can choose from and quickly deploy. And the last thing that we give you is this unique intelligence. And this is something that you cannot get on premises, and it is crucial to staying ahead of cybersecurity threats. So with the secure foundation, staying with the theme of threes, there are three different ways that Microsoft secures the foundation. And the first thing is with our physical data centers. So we have over 50 regions, and that number is growing. And we take a very extensive, multi-layered approach towards securing our data centers. And what that means is that we have security controls in place, starting from requesting access to get into an Azure data center, all the way to getting to that data center floor. And that is to ensure that any unauthorized user does not have access to your data. And then the last thing is we have our data centers are certified to comply with the largest standard of industry leading compliance certifications. So when we move to the infrastructure, Azure is built on customized hardware, and we have security controls that are integrated into that hardware as well as the firmware. Our network also has built-in protections against DDoS to protect against things like volumetric attacks or protocol attacks. And then the last thing that we do from an infrastructure perspective is we have continuous testing and monitoring. So what we do is we have a red team that's constantly trying to break into Azure, and we have a blue team that's constantly defending against that. And this is to ensure that we identify any vulnerability before a bad actor can. And the last section with operational security is that Microsoft admins do not have access to your data. If a Microsoft admin did need access to your data, they would have to request access, and they would be granted the lowest level of permission necessary to complete that request. And we have 3,500 cybersecurity experts working in our Cyber Defense Operations Center and other Microsoft security experts that work 24/7, 365 days a year to ensure that your data and your business assets are protected. So just to kind of sum things up, these are things that Microsoft will do to secure the infrastructure when you are a customer in Azure. For more security, we provide built-in security controls to help you protect your data and mitigate risks quickly. And when we think about all of the different Azure security services that are available, to make sense of it all, we group it into these main areas. So we start with identity and access management. And you need to have security services in place to ensure that unauthorized users do not have access to your resources. And some of these security services include Azure Active Directory, multi-factor authentication, and role-based access control. Then you need to make sure that you have services in place to protect your data while it's in transit, while it's at rest, and while it's at use. And so some of those services would be Azure Storage, Azure Key Vault, and we've recently announced confidential computing. When we move up to network access, we need to make sure that you have a secure connection established from your on-premises environment to Azure, as well as securing things like your web applications. And this week at RSA, we are announcing the Azure DDoS Protection Standard, which is a control that will give you even more control over your DDoS protections. And then the last two categories of advanced threat protection and security management, I'm going to show you briefly. They fall into the service called Azure Security Center. So real quickly, how many of you are familiar with Azure Security Center? Kind of? Okay. So the great thing about Azure Security Center is that you now have one tool that you can see your security state, and you can monitor that security state across your on-premises and Azure environment. You can take advantage of our tools that help you reduce your exposure to threats. And it's also a service that uses machine learning to detect threats and allow you to respond to those threats quickly. And so before I show you Azure Security Center, I want to touch on our partner solutions. We have a vast partner ecosystem. So if you are using a third-party service on-premises and you love it, we absolutely want you to bring that to Azure and keep using it there. So I'm going to briefly switch to Azure Security Center. And Azure Security Center, when you come into the Azure portal and you're at your overview dashboard, Security Center is built into the Azure portal. So it makes it really simple for you to find it and deploy it. And once Security Center has launched and you've installed that monitoring agent either on your Azure virtual machines, another cloud, so Google or AWS's virtual machines, or on-premises, you see in one location your security state across compute, networking, storage and data, and applications. And this week at RSA, we are announcing a private preview for our new overview dashboard that will include things like monitoring for compliance. You'll be able to see the security state across security groups, and you will receive a compliance score. So if you're interested in that, talk to me after this session. I'm happy to help you get started with that. But let's say I want to figure out more about compute and see the security state of my virtual machines. I can look at my security state in two ways. I can go to my virtual machines and computers, and here I get a virtual machine by virtual machine view. And I like to call this the Christmas tree lights as we go across, because we will indicate to you as you're looking at your virtual machines in Azure, as indicated by the blue icons, or your virtual machines on premises, as indicated by the purple icons. You can instantly see if you need to if you need monitoring, if you need system updates, is endpoint protection missing, are there vulnerabilities, is there disk encryption. But if you want an aggregate of all of these security issues, you can come to the overview blade. And here you can see things like, all right, I have endpoint protection issues. I have to remediate some security configurations. I'm missing system updates. And so we don't just give you that visibility. We also make it really simple for you to take action and solve these known issues. So I'm going to click on endpoint protection. And again, it's going to use Azure monitoring to give me that instant insight to see that 17 of my 58 virtual machines are missing endpoint protection. Yikes. So I want to solve that. I want to be the security professional superstar of my organization. So I'm going to click on these 17 virtual machines to install endpoint protection. And right away, I'm either prompted to use a first-party Microsoft solution, which you can see here, or I could use a third-party solution. Whatever I choose, I'm going to click that solution, and that will take care of my endpoint protection issues. And if you want to remediate similar security issues, it's going to work that same way. So it makes it really simple for you to remediate these issues. The next thing that I want to show you is our mechanisms that we use to protect against threats. And one of those is our just-in-time virtual machine access. And what this is we know that our management ports, all right, microphone, we back? All right. Our management ports are subject to more than 100,000 attacks per day. And we know that our customers, they're trying to get in to access their management ports for good things like maintenance and management. And so with just-in-time virtual machine access, we give you the control to open your management ports for a certain amount of time needed. And then after that time, the management ports are shut. So Azure Security Center will automatically detect virtual machines that do not have just-in-time virtual machine access configured. And so if I want to enable it, I'm going to click on it. I'm going to click Enable Just-in-Time Virtual Machine Access. And I'm going to select the port that I want to do this from. And it's going to allow me to control things like the port, what's the protocol, where can I log in to do this type of maintenance or management, and for how long I want that port to be open for. So I know that I kind of have a lot of maintenance to do, so I'm going to keep it open for 3 hours. I'm going to click OK. And then when I log back into the Azure portal, I'm going to come to virtual machines that are configured. And this is where I can actually go in and do my maintenance and request access to these management ports. And you can see things like I'm going to have to turn it on. I'm going to have to choose my source IP. And then the time range will match the allotted time that I had just set when I was configuring that virtual machine. And then if we want to quickly respond to detected threats, this is where we get security alerts. And so like I was mentioning, Azure Security Center uses machine learning to detect things like RDP brute force attacks. And you will see in security alerts if the attack was successfully carried out or even if it was attempted. And either way, you can go into our investigation path to get some information about what that attack was, where it was carried out, how the environment was affected. And for even more information, I apologize that it's not loading, we take you to our investigation path where you get a visual and interactive experience looking at all the different entities that were affected by that attack. All right. And so the last pillar of Azure security is our unique intelligence. So going off of the theme of our conference, especially with our announcements yesterday, we're all working together to combat against cyber attacks. And so in order to do that successfully, we need to leverage collective intelligence. And so we are announcing this week at RSA the Microsoft Intelligence Security Graph. And what that is it's a consolidation of trillions of signals across all of our Microsoft products like Office, Bing, Skype, Outlook, as well as our larger partner ecosystem in one place for you to see threats as they're evolving in real time and take action. We use machine learning to process these attacks. So we're processing things like 450 billion authentications per month. We're processing 400 billion emails per month, 1 billion devices. And again, we're storing all of that intelligence in one place in the Microsoft Intelligence Security Graph so that you can keep pace with cyber threats as they're evolving. So just to hit it home, because this is a really short session and I wish I could keep talking to you for much longer, Azure is your trusted cloud. Azure is the cloud that can help you strengthen your security posture because of these three things, because of the secure foundation that Microsoft provides in terms of how it's managing the infrastructure, in terms of how it builds its data centers, and in terms of our operations teams that work 24/7/365 days a year to protect your business assets and customer data so that you can use your resources and your budget elsewhere in your enterprise. It's your trusted cloud because of the built-in controls that we provide. I was showing you Azure Security Center, and that is one of the services that gives you unified visibility across your hybrid cloud workloads, as well as helps you reduce your exposure to threats and respond to threats in real time. And the last thing is that this unique intelligence, again, we have an unparalleled number of trillions of signals that we are continuously processing and consolidating into the Microsoft Intelligent Security Graph to make sense of it all so that you can take the necessary action and take the appropriate next steps to protect against attacks. So, that is it for today. Again, thank you all of you for attending and stopping by. My name is Kelly. What I would love for you to do is scan this. Let me know what you think of the presentation. You can let me know if it was the greatest thing that you ever saw at RSA, or if it was the worst thing that you ever saw at RSA, and you're never going to get these 20 minutes of your life back. And if you want to find out more about what I just shared with you about Azure Security, our secure foundation, our built-in controls, and our unique intelligence, please stop by our Microsoft booth. I will be there. I would love to answer your questions. But if you don't feel like talking to me in person, that's OK. The leather jacket scares people sometimes. You can also go to this website, and you can get all of the information that Microsoft is announcing this week, as well as all of the sessions, including this one. They will be online there, so you can watch at your leisure or share with your colleagues. So thank you guys so much. Enjoy RSA. Have a wonderful week. And move to Azure. Secure your resources, secure your data in Azure. Thank you.